Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel Sugar Mama TV. I am Canna, and everyone obviously knows Rocco, and this is Julia. Now, Julia has very kindly popped over to my house to have a chat with me. She's turned up with banana bread, which we've all been chowing down on. She has been incredibly patient with helping me with Rocco, and as you can see, is now helping Rocco with his arts and crafts. Julia's been sharing with me how she found out about the $1,000 project and what she is doing with the $1,000 project. So Julia, thank you so much for coming.
This is so much fun. This is great. I'm loving this.
So, okay, first of all, can you tell me a little bit about yourself?
I live in Townsville, which for those of you who don't know, it's a beautiful coastal town in far north Queensland. I have twin girls, and they will soon be five. And I have a beautiful husband, and we also have two dogs.
Where did you find out about the $1,000 project?
April?
Yep. April this year you started doing the
$1,000 project. Yes, yes. So I was flicking through the entertainment section of the paper, and your book was reviewed. And so I was looking at it and I went, oh, what's this? The $1,000 project. I went, oh. And you know, the byline of, single mom saves $32,000 in a year. And I just went, what? How did she do that? I didn't go out and buy it.
Okay, that's alright.
I rented it, or borrowed it from the library.
Oh, good.
It was so good because it was this brand new, beautiful book. I opened it up. Oh, you bought it up. Here you go, sweetheart.
Thank you.
And what was then was really interesting is that you had in the back there, you know, this is my YouTube channel, follow me on Facebook, all that type of stuff. And I just went, oh, okay, let's go and have a look.
Yeah.
And then everything was just there, you know, everything in the book and so much more. I've been inspired by your minimalism approach, reducing your waste, all these little ideas.
And you mentioned like you have a mortgage, but you felt like you were just constantly treading water. Like,
yes.
You were trying to pay off, but it was like never getting any.
No, you'd pay a little bit off, and then the next month the interest would eat it up.
Yeah, it's all that extra work, it's just not,
that's
just
right,
not getting anywhere.
Yeah, so
that's right. That is such a frustrating feeling.
It is. And then our circumstances changed, obviously, because we had the girls.
Mm-hmm.
So we went from two incomes to then me being on maternity leave.
Yes.
And then in that time also too, we opened up our own business. So we went from a very steady, current, you know, very reoccurring paycheck to then, okay, we've got to wait till that invoice gets paid before we can do this, and we've got to, you know, take care of that business before we get paid, and you know,
it's
all that type
very,
of stuff.
It's quite a stressful thing to manage.
It is.
You have to become a master of managing not only your own personal cash flow, but also the business cash flow as
absolutely.
Well.
Absolutely.
So you're juggling a lot.
Yeah.
You started a $1,000 project.
Yep.
Tell me about your three goals.
Okay. So I was inspired about the idea of saving for something that was something for you. My goal is to take, it's to return back to Paris for a holiday. So my husband and I went before we had the girls, and I want to take my girls to Paris. My second goal is to pay off the mortgage.
Yeah.
And I've been inspired by your clips about passive income and just that sense of, look, you can do it. It's not a big, bad, scary world of finance. It's not something that you have to specialize in. It's something that you can just go, okay, save up a bit of money and put it in that account.
Okay.
Save up a bit of money and you know, buy some shares and do that. And I remember clearly your YouTube clip about just, you know, click on here and this is how I buy it, and it's easy.
It's so easy.
Initially,
you can buy shares within minutes. And also, you don't need to build a, you know, get overwhelmed yourself with what stocks and investments to pick. You can just go with a listed investment company, pick one listed investment company that invests in 60 or 100 different Australian industrial companies. I will list in the video description box below five different listed investment companies that do things like this. So you don't need to like be worried. However, you have built your own share
portfolio. I cheated a little bit, and I used the Sugar Mama investment portfolio as a guide. Take $500 rather than $1,000, and I would go, okay, I'm gonna buy $500 worth of that company. I've set myself a goal of 10 companies, and then I'll just keep reinvesting in those ones.
Since starting in April, so, I mean, gosh, you haven't done a year of this. Can you share how much you've made in extra payments towards your mortgage?
Yeah.
how much you've saved towards the trip to Paris so far. Yeah.
So far I've managed to pay off an extra $4,000. I've put $6,000 into our Paris account, mm-hmm. and I've also bought $5,000 worth of shares.
7 months?
7 months.
You have saved $15,000.
Wow.
Isn't it amazing how much things add up? And when you stop doing, like stop being, you know, proactively putting them into the separate yes. dedicated accounts,
yes.
it adds up. Yes. Now, can you please share with everyone, say, seven of your top like Julia hacks.
Oh my hack.
just to do like even just the little ones, because I think it's the little ones when you do them consistently.
Yes.
They add up and build up over time, and the impact of them is really quite powerful.
I use my credit card for flybys points.
Okay.
I found that flybys points get me more dollar for value.
Okay.
So
you use like a loyalty program with your credit
yes.
cards, but you always pay your credit card off.
Always pay my credit card off.
And yep. you have one little other trick you said.
Oh yes, so I have a float or a tab on my credit card, so it's always in credit $2,000.
So you never actually ever, even though you're using your credit card, you never actually owe any of it money.
No.
You prepay, you preload it.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
All right, give me another hack.
So another hack.
Sorry, Rocco has a new friend here.
We're having fun. Another hack is I've taken your eat up the bits
mm-hmm.
meals.
Oh, I'll eat up the bits. That's what I'm going to be doing tonight for dinner, is eating up the bits
yes.
in the fridge.
Zero waste, cleans out the fridge, and you can kind of then, you know, subconsciously start to meal plan for the next day.
Give me another hack.
Another hack. Online grocery shopping.
Oh.
Because I have a Coles credit card, I get free delivery.
Oh,
because
okay.
I pay my Coles credit card.
Wow,
yeah,
okay.
So I don't pay that $10 delivery fee.
Oh, even better, okay.
Yeah, so everyone has a Coles credit card.
Okay.
And I find that then I'm not buying extra stuff because I'm hungry
yep.
or because I've got the kids with me going, oh, mummy, can we have these biscuits?
Oh,
mummy, can we,
yep.
can I have this toy? Mummy, can I have this?
Yeah.
No, you just remove
yeah.
temptation that
and
way.
You can see the tally. When you go to checkout, you can see what it's adding up to online.
Yes.
In the store, if you've got 20 people standing around you and you've gone over your budget or your allowance on grocery shopping, it's quite mortifying going, okay, stop right there.
Yeah.
I'm gonna have to, what can I work out if I can put back and send back?
Yeah.
Both people just go, oh my God, I went well over, how embarrassing
yeah.
is my credit card.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's the thing about online shopping. Give me another hack, sorry, I'm drilling you.
Oh no.
What you've achieved in such a short period of time is so amazing.
It's pretty phenomenal, and it's just, it's about asking yourself, do I really need that? So an extra coffee, you know, throughout the day, do I really need that? No, just go and make yourself a cup of tea. You're okay.
You talked about rounding numbers up and down.
Oh,
can you talk me through that? Because I thought that was great as well.
So we have an offset account. All our pay goes into that, and then we just divvy out of that.
Yeah.
For instance, we've got, say, $2,261. Mm-hmm. I round it down to the nearest thousand. Mm-hmm. And so I'll take that $261, mm-hmm. and then I'll put that directly onto the home loan.
Not only has she just knocked $4,000 off her home loan, she's also saved almost $5,000 in interest off her loan that she didn't realize she had done. You invested. What did it feel like making your first investment in shares?
It was one of those things where, as I said before, shares always seemed like a foreign concept.
Yeah.
There is a lot of fear around investing.
Yes.
What if I lose it all? You know, all that hard-earned money gone. I know that was what was holding me back all these times. Like, oh, I shouldn't invest it. I should just pay off the mortgage and just kind of do that rather than, but just being introduced to this idea of passive income and watching your videos and just seeing how, like, you know, looking at that future impact and just going, oh, wait a minute, I can pay off the mortgage and have a little bit of that too.
Absolutely. What was it like when you received your first dividend check?
I was looking through the mail and I was like, oh, what is this? It was only for something like $10.51, but I screamed and I did this little dance.
Yeah, it's a heart moment. You
yes.
go, this is what investment
this is. This is what it is. And I'm just like, oh, where's my next one coming?
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
After just being reminded from one of your videos and changing the investment type, so changing from monthly to fortnightly.
Yep.
And
all those little things add up.
They do.
Never underestimate or turn your nose up at something small.
Because
so small. It is incredible what it does.
And so I rang the bank and I said, oh, hey, I've heard on the radio, I've seen on TV, there's other interest rates from other banks, so what can you do for me?
Mm.
And knowing that they don't want to lose my business, if you ring up and ask, guaranteed they're going to say, yeah, okay,
yeah.
We can help you out with something. It just so happened that the next month they did their annual interest rate rise, and so I rang them back again.
So you hustled, you negotiated a lower rate. You got out of the recent bank interest rate rise.
It wasn't a big deal. You don't have to be aggressive or anything like that.
And there's no harm in trying.
No.
Nothing to be lost, but so much to be gained.
I've now done it to almost every utility bill that I have.
All adds up.
It does.
I hope this video inspires other young families out there to just to have a go. See what you can do. If I told you back in April when you first started to do the $1,000 project, you will be $15,000 better off, would you believe me?
No, absolutely not. Yeah. No.
But when you set a meaningful goal within yourself that excites you, and you genuinely give it a really good go, it's mind-blowing what you can achieve. I stopped talking about it, I stopped thinking about it, I just simply did it, which is what you've done.
Yeah, and you start to not notice those little things.
Yeah,
You don't miss them.
And so much less stressful because you're actually seeing progress in your finances.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for watching. If you haven't subscribed already, please make sure you do. And of course, you can follow me on Instagram at sugarmama.tv. Ciao for now. Say wave, you can wave.
Bye!
Bye! Bye.